To really experience bank reconciliation, you need to do a second consecutive month. This means 2 months in a row of the same company. We will continue our story from the previous video and imagine we're doing the second consecutive month from the same company file in the same company. What should we look for when we do the second following month? Well, the ending balance of January must be the beginning balance of February on the bank statement and in the QuickBooks. If it's different, that means somebody changed something after you did January's bank reconciliation. The video that will follow this video will discuss how to find and fix those types of problems. The January outstanding checks should show up on February's statement. Usually, outstanding checks in 1 month clear the bank in the next consecutive month. The interest and service charge will be about the same dates as they are in January. That's because banks have monthly procedures that usually happen on the same day each month. And of course, the interest and service charge in our general ledger that show up on our trial balance will increase for the interest and the service charge for the second consecutive month. Before you begin, make sure you're using the file from the same web page as this video. That file should include all of January's transactions. It should include the January reconciliation that we did together in the previous video. And it should include the February transactions. In other words, it's just like fast-forwarding time 1 month from the previous reconciliation at the end of January to the end of February, and now the file is waiting for the February reconciliation. After we open the appropriate file, you can see in the trial balance that the bank fees expense was the amount of the bank service charge from the previous month's bank reconciliation. And you will notice the interest income is the amount that we put on the previous month's bank reconciliation. After we do this month's bank reconciliation, these two accounts will increase by the amount of fees and interest for this second month. Once again, we will open the Excel file that represents the bank statement and keep that open at the same time that we have our QuickBooks file open. We can click from the taskbar to switch back from one to the other. The first thing you should notice is that the beginning balance of February is the same as the ending balance of January from the previous video. You will also notice this February statement is in the same format as the January statement. The checks and deposits are all put together in the same transaction list in date order, and you're given a running balance. If you scroll all the way to the bottom, you can see the ending statement date, and you can see the ending statement balance. We have to open the Excel bank statement just like we did in the previous month and the previous video. We can switch back and forth between the Excel statement and our QuickBooks file by clicking on the task bar. The first thing you might notice is that the beginning balance of this month is the same as the ending balance of the previous month from the previous video. From the main menu, click Banking, Reconcile. The first thing you notice is that it says the last time it was reconciled was January 30th, and it assumes the statement date is February 28th. When we click back on our Excel bank statement and scroll to the bottom, we see that QuickBooks was correct. The statement date, which is the cutoff date of the statement, is February 28th. You may also notice that it remembers the correct beginning balance, which we confirm at the beginning of the statement is $27,698.07. If the beginning balance of the statement is not the same here in this window where it says beginning balance, it means somebody changed January transaction after you did the January reconciliation. That is a big problem, and we will learn how to solve that problem in the video that follows this one. Now, let's start recording the information. On February 28th, what was the ending balance of the bank statement? We scroll to the bottom, and we notice the ending balance was $46,205.04. Let's simply copy this into the correct field into QuickBooks. If you can't copy and paste, you have to type it in yourself. Notice QuickBooks remembers the bank fees expense as the account that will record the monthly service charge. Notice QuickBooks also remembers the interest income account that will record the interest that QuickBooks puts into our bank account. Notice QuickBooks also even remembered the day of the month that the bank usually records these transactions. In this case, QuickBooks is correct. The service charge was charged to us on the 23rd, and the interest was charged to us on the 17th. So now let's copy the transactions into QuickBooks as we mark it off the bank statement. The monthly service charge is $35. We highlight it in blue to mark it off. Remember, when we type in the service charge, do not include the negative sign. QuickBooks knows this is a negative number because you're putting it in the service charge field. The interest is on the 17th. Let's mark it off in blue as we copy it into QuickBooks. When we're finished with this window, we click continue and we're halfway home. Now let's clear the deposits. I notice the first deposit on the bank statement is 0005. You can clearly see that this deposit is the same money amount in both places. This was the deposit that was in transit from the previous month and in the previous video. It now cleared this month's bank statement. I'll mark it off as cleared by coloring the cells in blue, and I'll click the check mark in QuickBooks. The next deposit that cleared is down here if you scroll down. It's 0006. You can see that this deposit is the same money amount in both places. I'll mark it off as cleared in the bank statement, and I'll click the check mark in the margin in the QuickBooks file. The last deposit that cleared is all the way at the bottom of the statement. Deposit 0007 cleared, and you can see this deposit is the same money amount in both places. I'll mark it off as cleared on the statement, and I'll click the check mark in QuickBooks. Notice the cleared balance and the difference have changed since we clicked the check marks, and we notice we have no deposits in transit at the end of February. And now let's clear the checks. Check number 17, you can see, is the same money amount in both places. Let's mark it as cleared in the statement and click the check mark in QuickBooks. Check number 18, you can see, is the same in both places. Let's mark it as cleared on the statement and click the check mark in QuickBooks. Check number 19, you can see, is the same in both places. Let's mark it as cleared on the statement and click the check mark in QuickBooks. Check number 6 was outstanding from the previous month and in the previous video, and you can see that it cleared the bank statement this month. It's the same in both places, so I will mark it as cleared on the statement and I will click the check mark in the margin in QuickBooks. Check number 20 is the same in both places, as you can see. I'll mark it as cleared on the statement and I'll click the check mark in QuickBooks. Check number 21 is the same in both places. I'll mark it as cleared on the statement and I'll click the check mark in QuickBooks. Check number 15 is the same money amount in both places. Remember, the checks do not always clear the statement in numeric order. That's why on the statement, number 15 came after the others. But regardless, it's the same money amount, so let's mark it off in both places as cleared. Check number 16 is not on the statement. When I scroll all the way up and all the way down, I can see that check number 16 is not on the statement. You should not click the check mark here in the margin because check number 16 is our first outstanding check for February. Check number 22, you can see clearly, is the same money amount in both places. Let's mark it off as cleared and check it off from the statement. Check number 23 is the same in both places. Let's mark it off on the statement and click the check mark in QuickBooks. We're almost finished. Check number 24, your eyes can see, are the same in both places. Let's mark it off the statement and click the check mark in QuickBooks. Check number 25, you can see, is the same in both places. Let's mark it off on the statement and click the check mark in QuickBooks. Now we'll scroll all the way down to see the remaining checks. We have two checks remaining to mark as cleared. Remember, the process is finished when everything is marked off the statement. But right now, we only have two checks remaining. Now I moved the windows around a bit so you can see exactly what happens in this last part. The second to last transaction that will mark as cleared on the statement is number 26, because you can see check number 26 is 228036 in both places. Let's mark it as cleared on the statement and click the check mark here in the QuickBooks. Notice the cleared balance has changed, and now the difference is only $904.77. That's the amount of the one more remaining unmarked check that actually cleared the bank. At exactly the moment you mark off the last item from the bank statement, that's exactly the moment that the QuickBooks difference becomes zero. Notice check number 28 and 29 are outstanding checks. They are not on this bank statement. This bank statement is completely marked off. And now the difference between our records and the bank's records is clearly zero. We finish the process by clicking the button on the bottom, Reconcile Now. Click Display to see both the summary and the detail. You can browse the information and see that it highlights the main points of this month's bank reconciliation. And again, normally you would print the summary and print the detail and staple it to the February bank statement.